police officer? A pirate. A pirate. I saw lots of Harry Potter characters. Lots of them. One little girl came to my front door dressed in, I should explain for those of you who don't pay attention to popular culture, Harry Potter is a series of novels featuring children who belong to various schools at a school for wizards and witches called Hogwarts. And the best school, of course, is Gryffindor. So a number of kids were dressed up in Gryffindor outfits. And there was one girl who I thought was Hermione, so I said, are you dressed as Hermione Granger? And then I saw her glasses. She had Harry Potter's signature black, you know, circular glasses. And I said, oh, no, wait, you're Harry Potter. And she showed me her little necklace that had the little time travel thing that Hermione has. And she said, I'm both. So a few days ago in October, I dressed up as both. I was a priest at my daughter's wedding, and I wore my priest outfit. But I also wore a dress for the mother of the bride. Now, I brought this for you today because many people said, show me your dress, what are you wearing? So I just need to show you. A number of you wanted to see the dress. Here it is. In Germany, a place in Germany, so that she would one day marry a duke, a royal man. They had lots of little principalities, so princes were like kings. And she got married at age 14, and she had three babies. And while she was still married and a very young woman, she was very aware of the fact that she always wore fancy royal robes and that there were lots of poor people who didn't have enough to eat and they didn't have clothes to wear and they were also very sick. So she started taking clothes and food from the palace to feed the poor people. She did it so much that she was accused of stealing the jewels from the palace, and she had to prove to people at court, they kept maligning her and lying about her, so she would open her cloak and show them that she was just taking food and selling her own fancy clothes. Can you imagine me selling this? Then her husband died. She was only 20 years old, and her husband died on his way to the Crusades. He was going to battle, and he died of an illness. And her brother-in-law said, "Get that woman out of the castle. She's stealing all the wealth." And so he kicked her out. So here's a woman who was crying in grief. Her children were taken away from her. Her brother-in-law conspired against her to kick her out of her home. And she said, "Fine, give me my dowry." A dowry is like a big pile of money that your father gives to the prince when you get married so that they have your wealth. And they gave her her dowry, and she built a hospital for sick people, for poor sick people who couldn't afford to go to the doctor. Eventually, with more fighting in her kingdom, she was restored to her palace, and she insisted on wearing poor clothes and starting another hospital for poor people. And she was made a saint, because she said, "I want to look like poor people, I want to be with poor people, I want to take care of them, because they are the most like Jesus to me. And so I want to put on their clothing and change my look." So you might think from that story, and even from the gospel message today, that Jesus is saying, you must be poor, you must be hungry if you're going to follow me. But he doesn't actually say that. And we know that because the people that he picks to follow him aren't all poor. Jesus' followers are rich, poor, smart, foolish, strong, weak, tall, short, white, Asian, black, Filipino, Latino. Every shape of humanity is following Jesus. So he makes it clear you don't have to do that. But he does say, you have inherited the kingdom. That's what we heard Sophia's mom read, that we have inherited something. So do you know what inherit means? Okay, what does it mean? You get something that your parents have, right? So typically what happens is when relatives die, they have a document, that a piece of paper that says what they give away to their relatives, their money, their property, and so on. But what did we inherit from God? Has God given you any money or houses? Not yet. I haven't quite seen them yet. I mean, maybe, but what did we inherit? Faith, which comes through grace. Grace. We inherited the cloak of grace, and it is better than the invisibility cloak, even more powerful than the invisibility cloak, because the cloak of grace totally transforms us into something more special and beautiful than we are on our own. It's the royal garment of the royal priesthood of following Jesus, and while you can't see it, it changes you when you put it on. It protects you when you put it on. So, the question is, how do we look like saints? How do we put it on so that we look like Jesus? So for St. Elizabeth, it was taking care of the poor people and making sure that her being rich didn't set her apart from other people. But there's another way we can do it, and Jesus says it in the gospel today. At the very end, remember, he says, blessed are you, and woe to you, woe to you. And then he says, but I say this to you who listen. Did you hear it? Love your enemies. Love your enemies. The most radical thing you can do to put on the cloak of grace is to actually love people who can't stand you and want to get rid of you. It's to forgive people who have hurt you. This is the most special way to put on the cloak of grace. And Jesus says it. He says, but I tell you that, listen, one thing. He says, forgive your enemies or love your enemies, and then he explains how to do it. Now, the reason I know that he wants this is that whenever I am tempted not to forgive somebody, they've hurt me, I find them annoying, they ruined my life in some way, whenever I think, yeah, this time, God, I don't have to, not that one, there's always a person in my life, a friend, a sister, coworker, who says, I am never going to forgive that person for doing that to you. And then I think, I hear that. I am never going to forgive. And then I think, that is a sign that I haven't finished forgiving that person because you're still hurting about what they did to me. And I wasn't even aware that you were still hurting about what they did to me. And so what I do to forgive them is I just say, what am I caring about that? And I just throw it off. It's like a heavy chainmail that weighs a lot. It's like a hot Halloween costume on a hot night. Just take it off. Say, I give that up. And instead, I want to wear the cloak of grace. I forgive you so that my sister or my friend can forgive you and let it go. Love that person. Love that enemy. That's how we transform ourselves. That's how we put on the cloak of grace. And why do we do it? It transforms us. And we do it because God does it for us every day in every way. God gave us the cloak of Jesus and his grace to cover us. And so the least we can do